Madame de Pompadour, the famous mistress of Francis King Louis-Quinze, sponsored the best artists and craftsmen of her time, among them Jean-Claude Galuchat. Jean-Claude Galuchat was a master craftsman of a lost art. He was a leather craftsman and boxmaker. In his shop in Paris, he manufactured the finest leather-covered cases, books, sheaths, chests, and small furniture items. So why am I telling this story? Because sometime before 1748, Jean-Claude Galuchat discovered a tanning process to soften and refine the skin of stingray by the use of sandstone and pumice. It is said that Madame de Pompadour purchased one of the first items with this new material and that she became a great fan of ray skin. After Galuchat's death, ray skin leather was named after him in French. Unfortunately, someone made a mistake and dropped one letter of his name. Welcome to my review of another Le Tien knife, the Le Tien Galuchat by Claude Dauzon. Of course, the use of fish skins to make clothing or leather casings is very old. As you probably know, ray skin was used early on for wrapping the handles of Japanese swords. The Le Tien Galuchat comes in this black presentation box. Included is a guarantee certificate and a small piece of paper which confirms that this is real ray skin and not a fake. Plus, there is a little tool for adjusting the pivot screw. The overall design follows the usual style of a Le Tien knife. What's special about this knife is not only the use of ray skin, it also features a liner lock. Most traditional Le Tien knives are slip joints. And with some practice, you can even open the knife with one hand. As for the specs, the closed length is 125 mm. The overall length is 218 mm. The blade length is 94 mm. The blade thickness is 3 mm. The weight comes in at 134 grams. Now let's take a closer look at the handle design. There are several layers. The most outer layer is a skeletonized cage-like liner. This way, the edges of the next layer, the ray skin, are protected from wear or damage. Then come the usual inner liners. But please note that the locking liner is yet another separate layer of its own. As I already mentioned, you can open the knife with one hand by pressing on the protruding end of the tang. The liner snaps firmly in place in the center of the blade tang. The detent is very good. The blade, however, is not perfectly centered, but it's nothing to be worried about. The blade shape follows the well-known design pattern of the Le Tien knife. The mirror-polished blade is flat ground and has a secondary bevel. The blade steel is X50CR MOV15, a stainless steel that is commonly used for high-end kitchen cutlery. It takes a decent edge and is easy to sharpen. Claude Dauzon's Le Tien Galuchat is an interesting and novel interpretation of this popular knife pattern. The polished finish of the stainless steel creates a classy contrast to the black ray skin. I'm sure Madame de Pompadour would have liked it too. Thanks for watching and take care.